So this is a video going through trying to show you guys how to solve some of the problems that I gave you today for your practice test. So for this one, we talked about right, how much work is it to lift a 20 kilogram sack of potatoes vertically 6.5 meters. Okay, so we'll need two equations, right? So we'll need the work equation, which is just W is equal to force times distance. Right, so the only problem is they didn't give us force. So really what we need to have is we need to have the force equation as well. Force is equal to mass times acceleration. Right, so because we said we lifted it vertically, that indicates a G. Right, so the gravitational constant. So in this one I'm just going to use 10 as G. Okay, so now if we know that, we can say that the mass, which is up here, right, force is equal to the mass, which is 20 kilograms times the acceleration, which is 10 meters per second. Right, so basically I take 20 times 10, so our force is going to be equal to 200 newtons. Right, so now we have our force part. So we finished the first part. So now to figure out work, so we're just going to have to say work is equal to force, which is 200 newtons. 200 newtons of force times the distance, which the distance it tells us right here is 6.5 meters. Right, so now I'm going to take that and I'm going to multiply that by 6.5. Right, so I'm going to take my calculator and I'm going to say 200 times 6.5 is equal to 1300. That 1300 is going to be in joules. Remember, work is in terms of joules. So I'm just going to have 1,300 joules, okay? So that's why this one was B today. Right, so let's go ahead and go to the second one. Okay, so now, second one, we're going to look at this. So now we have newtons. Okay, so we want to find out, right, how much work is it going to take using 30 or 20 newtons of force. Okay, so remember work is equal to force times distance. Okay, so I have my 20 newtons, and now I have my distance right here. So then I'm going to take 20 times 6. Right, so now I'm going to take that, 20 times 6, equals 120 joules. Okay, so remember, newtons is a force. Okay, so we can cross off all the newtons. Okay, so we have 120 joules. That's how we got that one. Okay, and then the next one. Right, so this one here, so we're going to do this one. So we have 30 newtons of force. Okay, so now the issue here, right, work is equal to force times distance. So they tell us a distance, but what they say here is they say we're only pushing down for 10 minutes. So now we have 10 newtons of force times the distance. It did not go anywhere, so it's just going to be zero. So that's going to be equal, anything times zero is zero. Okay, so the work done on that particular one is going to be 0 joules. Like that. Okay, so then question number four. Okay, so on this one, first you can look at that and you can say you have a 45, 45, 90 triangle because both the sides here are equal to each other. Right, but you can look at it and go, okay, we'll solve it just like we would anything else. Okay, so I want to find the angle theta here, right, so I have over here, right, this is the hypotenuse. Okay, from this one, we walk across this way, this is our opposite side, and this is our adjacent side. So I go over here, SOHCAHTOA, okay, so all I have is opposite over adjacent, so that's going to be tangent. Okay, so I'm going to say the tangent of theta is equal to the opposite side, right, which is 3, divided by the adjacent side, which is 3. So then we go to our calculator over here and we say, okay, well, right, 3 over 3 equals, then we hit the second and tangent, okay, and it pops up with 45 degrees. Okay, so now I can say, yes, that is 45 degrees, right, because inverse tangent of 1 is going to be 45 degrees. Okay, so we can say we got that one. There. So this one here. Okay, so I'll clear our calculator. So it says to find this side here. Right, so meaning I know the angle here. I know this side here, but I don't know that side there. Okay, so right, I'm going to label all my sides. That's the hypotenuse. This is going to be the opposite angle. This down here is going to be the adjacent. So then I can say the opposite over adjacent, or right. So now I can say opposite over adjacent. So I'll do SOHCAHTOA. Right. So CAH. So adjacent over hypotenuse. We'll use that one. Or we're going to use opposite over adjacent. It's going to be the TOA. Okay. So now I can take the tangent. Tangent of 32 degrees over 1 is equal to, right? So the opposite side, which is x, divided by the adjacent side, which is going to be 13. Okay, so then I cross multiply like that. So x is equal to tangent of 32 degrees times 13. Okay, so on my calculator, I would just put, right, 32 tangent times 13 equals 8.12, so basically that's 8.1 if I'm rounding it to the tenth place. Okay, so that would be 8.1. Okay, right there. Okay, and our last one. Okay, so essentially we're doing the same thing, except we're finding all the adjacent angles. So what I would do, this up here, 24 minus 90, 24 minus 90, okay, so the other side's going to have to be 66 degrees, because remember all sides have to add up to 180, and I know this is 90. Okay, so then I check all those say 66, so, now the other thing I would do is I would double check, so side BC, which is this side over here, so this guy's our hypotenuse, this guy's our opposite side, that's our adjacent side. Okay, so what you can do, I would go over here and I'd say opposite over hypotenuse. Okay, so that's going to be sine of 24 degrees over 1 is equal to the opposite sine divided by 14. Okay, so I cross multiply, our opposite sine is equal to 14 times sine of 24 degrees. So I go over here on my calculator, I'd say, okay, well, sine of 24 degrees, so 24 sine times 14 equals that, which is 5.7. So I'd look over here and I'd say, hey, look at that, side BC is 5.7, that's the only one that says that, that tells me that's the right answer. Okay. So that's how I would do the last one. Okay. Any other questions, you can go ahead and send me any questions. So.